Все может получиться.
Sportbets.com – уникальное место для настоящего геймера. Только здесь возможны ставки на киберспортивные события. Ты знаешь толк в самых популярных играх и готов рисковать? Смотри регулярные трансляции и зарабатывай реальные деньги. Sportbets.com – живой азарт и холодный расчет.
And we are back once again, ladies and gentlemen, so welcome to the show. Back after a bit of an incredible game there between NIP and Titan, and it was everything that we could have hoped for. What a game. And Vendetta, now we have you back with actual audio. It wasn't even your fault, I'm so sorry. It was actually the mumble server that fucked everything up.
Yeah, I was... I guess I was the victim.
You were the victim. It just yeah, it was discrimination, racism, Norwegian.
Yeah, I blame UK hosting.
Yeah. Damn.
But yeah. I did get to see the game. And holy hell.
That was
that was pretty goddamn impressive.
Yeah, because you know what? Some of the games we've been seeing, and I guess it's been a little bit obvious that I've been a little bit annoyed at some of the teams for making some silly mistakes. But then you get a game like that and you suddenly remember exactly what Counter-Strike is all about and why it can be and this is, you know, I just want to say when we see a game like that, that's when I think if we had a Counter-Strike international tournament, that's why I think it would be a massive success, because of that.
Oh yeah, and actually I think we've been pretty lucky with most or quite a lot of the grand finals we've had in CS tournaments just in general.
Yeah.
So, just imagine if we could get something similar to the TI3 finals for CS.
Yes.
Like, the hype would be so insane.
Yeah, and I think actually there's even, not to rain anything on Dota's parade, because I think Dota is such a cool game, and I actually think this last international, apart from the finals, had some absolutely astonishing games. I was really just really glued to the screen most of the time. But I think actually even in Counter-Strike, there's maybe even a higher chance of having a really great finals because of the... I don't know, I just feel like a lot of the teams are really, really close at the very top in a different way. I feel like it's hard to have a really bad finals in Counter-Strike now. Maybe at, you know, last year it would have been a little bit easier because of the whole NIP Titan thing or very games being the only two teams, but I think now it's hard to have a really boring finals in Counter-Strike.
Yeah, you could go there. I mean, the top six teams, top six to eight now are so damn close. I think you got a good point, Anders. It really is. The teams you expect to get to the semis, you know, they usually do. You know, quarters are usually pretty damn good. It's pretty much like the top eight usually is really nice. Like, it's tough to find a bad match in all of them, right?
Yeah. So, and in addition to that, you also have the occasional dark horse that pops out at tournaments. And I think one of the reasons why it's in some ways easier to get a good finals is because you can't really snowball in CS to the same extent as you do in Dota.
No, that's true.
I mean, you can get off to a 5-0 start, which is great, but that doesn't mean you're going to win the game. If you're carrying Dota that gets off with, you know, a first blood and four more kills within the first 10 minutes of the game, you're going to have a bad time.
What was that one Dota game? There was one Dota game where one team had like a Spectre, and it was the Spectre that got the first kill, like this last international.
That was the most ridiculous
thing I've ever seen. Because, I mean, the game doesn't get decided by that first kill, but you sort of had a feeling, well, that might just be it. Like, what are they going to do now?
Yeah, it's like, oh, it's a really it's a late game hero that's super slow to get online. Oh, he's getting a first blood. Oh, he's getting more kills.
Yeah,
he farm.
Yeah, that was a funny game. Obviously not for the people losing, but I remember that one. Now, we do have the last game of the evening here. Just want to give a big shout out to all of you who are sticking with us here. Still a lot of people tuning in, and we're really happy with that. Obviously, how much, what was the peak record for that game? Was it 65,000 people watching?
65.
Yeah. Wow. So that's incredible.
Insane.
Yeah, so if you joined in and watched, you know, and you're watching this channel for the first time because of that game, maybe you saw it on the front page or something, then a big welcome to the channel. Of course, this is Room on Fire, and we do Counter-Strike casting and a lot of it here. That was an ESCA game. Now we're back into the SLTV Star Series, and it's the Season 10 version of that one. And we have ESC Icybox versus virtus.pro, two Polish teams playing up, and I actually can't remember the last time I've seen ESC play versus virtus.pro.
I can recall it, well, not exactly, but it's a couple of months ago, but it was a different iteration, a slightly different iteration of the ESC team. Yeah. And they played
on
Nuke.
Was it with Lord on it still?
Yeah, I think so, and it was on Nuke, and I think the game ended 16-10 in favor of virtus.pro.
Alright then, so that's actually a little bit closer than you'd maybe think, because virtus.pro is definitely a top-level team, and ESC is, I guess, the second-best team in Poland, and I'm not even sure what the third-best would be. I actually do know some of the Polish teams, but I just don't recall their names right now, in fact. But yeah, big thanks to everyone who's been subscribing as well. It's a really big help to us, and we do appreciate it. And as a bit of a payback, tomorrow we're going to be giving out a Karambit knife, because tomorrow we're hosting our own tournament as well, which is the Case King of the Hill cooled by Alpenfrun, and that's going to be with LDLC, with NIP that we just saw, and then with Na'Vi in the grand finals as well. So it's going to be really sick. Two great best of three games are coming up tomorrow, and you can't miss it. And if you want to win more than just a knife, maybe, you can go and follow the Facebook link at the bottom of the page, which takes you to our sponsor's Facebook. All you have to do is like the page, and you can win a Zoe keyboard. So that's also worth it. But now I think we actually do have a knife round coming up finally, guys. So welcome to the show, everyone, and just enjoy this.
Yeah, different thing entirely. Apparently more than 20 million people watched the International for Dota 2.
Holy
2 million gosh. Concurrent. And that's not counting what was on TV with ESPN, MTG Europe, CCTV China.
Now see, that it makes me, that's actually a big relief, because that's
I was worried
one,
too,
yeah,
for a little bit.
That was the one thing I was worried about for this International, was if the numbers weren't going to add up, but that sounds like it's been very successful, so well played, Valve.
Kind of makes me wish that the production had been a bit better.
Shots fired.
Ooh. Shots fired. But yeah, I was a little bit disappointed with the production. But yeah. Still, you know, 20
some of the first
people,
day
that's
issues.
Pretty impressive.
Yeah, some of the first day issues were a little bit tricky. I will say this though, tuning in and listening to the casters and everything, I've got to say the casting team, like overall, I think did really, really well. I was really pleased by that. So.
Oh yeah, Toby, LD,
yeah.
Lumi,
exactly.
Like it was solid.
Yeah, I enjoyed it a lot, and James did a great job of doing the hosting in between
as
well.
Still look like a hobo.
But speaking of something completely different, virtus.pro versus ESC I think what we can safely assume is one of virtus.pro's best maps.
Indeed.
So,
oh yeah,
what kind of predictions do you have for me?
Actually, because this is a domestic matchup, I think it's going to be a little bit more tricky than we maybe think, but I'm going to go with virtus.pro winning 16-12 here.
16-12?
Yeah. Yeah, taking into account
impressive.
The virtus.pro just back from vacation, and they aren't going to be like too... I think maybe ESC could surprise us here. I'm going to go for a surprise.
16-8, VP.
Okay, well, I applaud you on your positivity and optimism, but I'm going to call it 16-5. At best.
All right.
Heyo.
Fair enough. We'll have to find out how it's going to go here. Already, Innocent has gone down, and he's one of the key players on the ESC, so that's not so good. Snags drops, but they're actually running through. They're not sticking into the bomb side here. They're trying to throw the CT side for a loop. Great shot from Neo. Catches Minai's mid-air, and now Sierra is down there. Neo is going to come looking for him, and actually Neo goes down, so it's very much back and forth. But the time here, 35 seconds left. Taz is in the right position, and is not going to be able to catch the kill crossing over, so this should be a plant coming in here now from ESC.
Yeah, he's got some nades though. He does have some nades, but he decides not to use them. He's actually just going to try and rush the site with his teammates here. Taz taking some fire. Moves, that is all over the place. What is going on?
I have no idea. This is crazy. Mouse is now looking here. One guy jumping through, and Mouse lives for another second here. Now Pasha trying to run away. He wants to wait until Bailey shows up, which is a really good idea. Now they're going to try and double team him, and that works out just fine. Pasha gets the triple. I think ESC probably should have won that round at the end, but I mean, when Pasha's on fire like that, it's pretty hard to stop him.
Dude, Pasha had 8 HP since the beginning of the round. He got headshot when he got the kill mid, and still got another 2 frags with 8 HP. That's not what you want to be seeing when you're ESC, right? That Pasha is just like, no fear. 8 HP, I still get 2. Like, it's like, okay then, Pasha.
Now, I also think Bialy's frag in mid was huge for them, because that could have potentially just crumbled the retake completely for VP.
Yes, you're right. That was definitely important. And a good position from the terrace side, but couldn't make enough of it here. Good grenade from Neo lands right on Michu, so he's going to be going down. They did lose Pasha, and again, VODS.pro going with some funky buys here. I mean, Neo with the MP7.
He does this consistently, and I love him for it. I really wish... Well, actually, now he swaps it out for an M4. Not too surprising. But yeah, I really like the fact that he picks up the MP7. It's a really good SMG, even though it doesn't do that all that much damage to armor.
You can just run and gun with it. That's the thing.
Exactly.
It's like Pro 90 territory. Just run around, shoot people in the face with it, mow people down in droves right now. That's what Snax is going to give us a demonstration of. That's like a double, like one of those headshots was through the head of the other guy.
Yes.
And that's how you do it, Snax.
Yeah.
I mean, if they're going to offer themselves up like that and just, you know, stand in one line, it's almost rude not to take that double kill, I think. You know, that's just bad mannered. So Snax making sure he takes their offering, you know, he's a kind god in that sense, just receives it. And now it's into the third round.
All right, let's see where we can go here. Third round buy because of that buy in the pistol round for ESC. Neo about to eat some sick nade damage. He tries to return fire. Doesn't do nearly as much. Mousinho drop down to 94.
And
so far,
be
the opening shot's
again.
Actually fairly even.
And Neo, softened up by that grenade, going to go down immediately to the body shot from the AK there. So that's a pretty good start coming out here from ESC. Man, they need to win this round, and a lot more here in the first half, I think. Oh, Manize with a very quick reaction. Bailey goes down. That's actually very impressive.
Man, Snax isn't going to fare any better here. Manize is on a tear now. He's going to be able to block off CT with the smoke as well. That opens up the bomb site. The bomb is still rotating in through T-Pit, but ESC, they already have this bomb site under control. Pasha is trying to just sneak his way in, see if he can catch somebody off guard. He will spot one. Innocent mad spray from Pasha, and he gets nothing for it.
Oh, and Minaj takes him down. This is so far a flawless round from ESC, and Michu, long range, going to be taking down Taz. So pretty nicely done here. ESC already in the third round, and that actually puts VODS.pro almost on an eco. If they force it up here, it's not going to be perfect.
And I don't think they're going to force it up. Had they gotten a couple more kills, that would have definitely been a possibility, because then they would have the opportunity to actually break ESC's economy again. But the way that round turned out there, that's not a possibility.
Alright, so now Snags down to 10 HP with a scout in the middle, and ESC looking to equalize the score in this round if they can just avoid running into that, which Bailey just did onto Minaj. That's what you want to avoid. And then also that thing from Neo. You want to avoid all those things that we just saw. Don't do it. I mean, what the hell?
Right now, actually, this is looking... Until Mouse actually finds that kill on Pasha, who's pushing in, this is still looking like VP in a pretty decent spot. Michu is going to find Bialy, though, over at Electric. And still looking... I mean, they're still looking right now. ESC, not a whole lot going as far as what's on the table.
They kill Neo, and that's the A-bomb sign, and then also Snacks goes down, so that's a little bit better, but... Man, that was looking scary for a while. Taz going to be alone in a 1-on-3 here, so... And actually, Michu's going to find him already. Goes down, unfortunately, so not many rifles saved. I mean, in terms of economic damage, it's a really good round coming out here from VODS.pro already, and I think Taz could have almost killed another guy, but now he's looking for a gun.
Yeah, and I think the smart option here is just to run away with that AK, even though he potentially could do some significant damage to ESC's economy. They've already gotten the bomb down, so I don't think it's actually worth it.
No, they're on the CT side as well, and, you know, having to buy one rifle less here is definitely going to be nice for VODS.pro, who, you know, after winning the pistol round, haven't been up to the greatest start here. We're into the fifth round already, and let's try and see if the ESC, the underdogs here, can do a little bit more. I mean, that one round that they won, the first one that they won, not this one, but the last one, was very impressive. So if they can keep on that level, it's going to be great.
Yeah, this is all about momentum at this point. VP, now it's their opportunity to put a halt to it all. Pasha's got his AWP, not playing his usual spot. Yes, he is. He's still up in window. But ESC aren't even putting up a fight for it. They aren't interested in going for a mid-round play. They are looking towards an A smoke round, it seems.
Yeah, which means Bailey's going to be in an interesting spot here, because if Snacks ends up on the wrong side of the smoke, Bailey's the only one inside the bomb site, and I think they've even spotted him. Flash going to rain in here. Yeah, they definitely know he's in this corner, I think. Yep, jumps right down. Zero gets the kill. Snacks goes down, and now things are looking increasingly rough here for virtus.pro, although they do get the one kill in return, but it's still a 2-on-2 with the bomb down.
Dude, Benize is playing out of his mind right now. Three frags for him. Pasha now gets caught. He's rotating around to CPL. He's looking to catch Minai's, who's still in that A apartment, and Pasha can't do it. Minai's with a quad kill. And that was crucial. His performance that round was crucial because ESC didn't use any nades. They actually threw a smoke mid, I think, just to kind of throw virtus.pro for a loop, and then they walked out onto the site and landed the shots.
And how did Pasha not at least kill Minai's? I mean, winning the whole 1-on-2 was maybe a little bit tricky, but he should have pretty hit on that kill on Minai's. I think choosing to spray at that range maybe wasn't the smartest idea.
I think you're right. I'm actually surprised that VP are leading so heavily towards mid control. Obviously, it's great to have mid control, but they actually opted to have four people towards mid.
There was a lot about it there. Now it's just going to fall apart yet again. ESC deciding to go for yet another smoke play onto A. Walking right out. Look at this. Spiro has no fear. Goes for one. Nearly going to find the headshot on Taz, but the nade does the job. And once again, it's Pasha all alone. 1v4.
It's a really good shot from Pasha. That was actually pretty impressive. But it doesn't matter in terms of winning the round. So we're going to be looking at 2-4 scoreline here. And Pasha trying to save a rifle. I mean, ESC, they're off to a 6 start, especially because of Minai's 10-0-3 scoreline right now.
I think Minai's is the one who's making the difference, and it's almost a bit of like this Adrian feel to it, because he keeps walking out of A apartments and just getting kills. So, not walking through smoke per se, but he's still just not getting stopped. Pasha manages to get a parting shot as well, so that was nice. Saves that AK, and he's actually not going to buy an AWP, just straight rifles here for VP.
Vendetta, how do you feel about that 16-5 prediction?
I'm going to stand by it. This is where virtus.pro shuts it down.
Alright, well, I'm glad you're not just giving up on them here, because I think they can still come right back into this game pretty quickly. Neo up in the middle here, walking right past them, all of them, and Neo's going to spray down two people really quickly, leaving Taz alone on the bombsite, but that's obviously a great start for virtus.pro. Mouse very low on health, easy kill for Taz. Goes for a second one, but he's actually going to be dropped by Minai's, who's now alone in a 1-on-4.
And Snacks is already out from the B apartments. He gets spotted, however, Minai's is alive. Back of the site, picks up one, gets the headshot, gets two, takes out Neo, swaps out the AK, but he got greedy. Snacks put an end to him. Trying for the style points there, but still, two kills from Minai's when he should have been just taken out in a crossfire. That was really fine.
And really confident kills as well. Some real precision put into that. I'm really impressed by Minai's right now.
No doubt about it. He is stepping up. And this is why ESC have got the rounds that they do. Two of those rounds in large part are due to Minai's just stepping in and owning VP. So we have to see if he's capable of it again. I mean, there's still plenty of rounds left in this half. Another 7. So plenty of time for him to shine.
All right, and he's going to be running out right past the smoke that just popped up. And I understand the timing he was looking for, but Bailey was not going to miss that kill. So finally a good start for virtus.pro, who need all the rounds they can get right now, because they are economically and also just in the game a little bit behind here.
I'm actually surprised to see Minai's going for it or committing to it that much, seeing how passively the rest of his team was set up, because there's no way they can actually capitalize on anything he actually does if he gets the kill on Bialy. Sure, it's
he's still
create
a teenager,
then. But yeah,
he thinks
yeah.
He's immortal.
But yeah, like, sure, it would have forced a rotation, but the rest of his team was kind of just lurking about towards mid. Nothing more. So a bit of an odd decision, but obviously I think he's kind of that in that zone where he thinks he can do it all.
Yeah, maybe it was. And that can be a problem, obviously, because Yeah, if you try once or twice and it works, that's great, but if you keep doing it over and over and it fails, that's definitely not what you want to do. Taz in the corner here takes down the bomb on Mouse, not going to get the second one. Innocent comes up with a kill. Neo has to stay alive, just wait for his teammates right here. Going to pick off Innocent, leaving Ciro alone, and he's going to get the one kill, but it's too late. He will be taken down by Ali, so good round overall from Virtus Pro, I'd say.
I agreed. They're starting to find themselves again. Now, what I'm really interested in is whether Manize is going to once again go for that A push. He's got another AK, one nade, and they've actually got full rifles across the board here for ESC, but this is it. This is now the money that they need to be, well, this is when they need to really start connecting and at least getting a plant so that they can buy in the next round. Look at VP changing it up, though. They're going to flash into A apartments, and guess who's there? Manize, and he gets the kill versus Bialy.
A surprise from Manize has a really nice ring to it, doesn't it? Wish we could be casting ESC a little bit more. Maybe they are going to be a much better team, because they've actually been consistently, I think, playing better and better and better. It'd be great to have two Polish teams. Who says we can't have that? I mean, the one Polish team that's there is, you know, a contender to be one of the best teams in the whole world. So maybe there's enough of a talent pool in Poland to make a second team. That'd be great.
Oh, Pasha alive. Pasha continues. This is his favorite spot, but eventually they catch him. Taz rotating over from B site will find Manize, however, so he's out of the picture now. It's in a 2-on-2. Taz rotating in, just barely missing the opportunity to pick out Mouse, who is already free-firing when Snacks goes through. Very nicely done here so far, but this is going to fall apart.
And you really don't want to play the shooting through smoke game against Snacks, because he's one of the best players in the world at doing it somehow. They're looking for the bomb, which is more difficult than it seems, and Snacks is going to find it eventually. So there is the round. Is he delaying the defuse? Yeah, they wanted to pick up that AWP. So fair enough, it's going to be 5-4. And I think, I mean, Ven, you sort of said it. Now is the time where Virtus Pro step it up, and I'm not even sure you're completely wrong here. I think that's what we saw yesterday when we saw Virtus Pro play against, who was it?
On this Navi.
Navi, and they actually took a while, didn't they, before they really woke up?
Yeah, well, the first few rounds, I think it was like the first 9 rounds in the Navi VP game was just a really back and forth game. Kind of like this one, actually. With C's coming up big for Navi, especially. So it's actually kind of similar. So we wouldn't be surprised to see Virtus Pro kind of slowing things down.
Oh, they back off? Are they really backing off here? Bialy's going to back off, but look at Snacks. He's right there around the corner at pit. Point man here for VP. And he instantly gets picked off.
It's not really ideal, but Pasha is there. There's the one. There's the two. Can we get a third one as well? No, it's going to be Violet to pick that one. And finally does get his triple kill, Pasha. So, Pasha with a lot of confidence is always a scary thing. I mean, we're talking about Virtus Pro being one of the best teams in the world. Well, Pasha is one of the best players in the world, statistically speaking. So, definitely not surprising to see him do that, but it's still kind of a pleasure to watch him do that stuff.
Oh, yeah, he's about as good as you can get in CSGO. I think it's fair to say that he's probably a top 5 player in the world.
Yeah, I would agree. Grenade, and actually, this time, Snacks goes down. Pasha does get the kill on Manize, which has to be considered a pretty good kill. That was up in the apartments. Manize maybe playing a little bit too predictably, do you think that, Ben? Because he's been doing that apartments push for a while.
Well, it's been working for him so far, so I can see why he wants to test his faith, really, and try it as much as possible. And it doesn't really seem like anyone else on ESC is able to get any sort of opening on other spots of the map, so they kind of have to go for it, in a way.
It seems like it. Michio's looking towards short to see if Neo's going to push down there. But then Pasha... Oh! Misses two shots. Finally gets the kill afterwards with the CZ, but that was far too close for comfort there. Pasha running at risk.
I was going to say, that was really scary once he missed that first shot, but now Mouse is kind of alone. Pasha's already got a triple and maybe looking for the quad. He's got a couple of triple kills already, and he's actually aiming the right way, but he didn't spot him crossing over there. So now Mouse has a chance to get at least a kill here, but now the smoke is up. That makes it really tough.
He might still be able to catch Pasha off guard here. Oh, he sees the gun barrel.
Yeah, Bialy in the back takes him down to 1 HP, then the Molotov to follow. And Mouse is going to be running away. Well, it's nothing to do with the fire, but he is going to fall down and still sort of comes pretty close to burning there. 7-4.
Mouse had an AK there, right?
Yeah.
And he headshotted Neo?
Did he? I did not see that.
I'm convinced that was a headshot, but it somehow did 78 damage. I'm not really sure how that worked out.
Could it have been through the railing here? There's like a railing going on.
I thought they removed that. Like, the damage fallout from that, but who knows?
I think it doesn't stop nades anymore, but if you shoot through it, you're still trying to shoot through metal. I don't know.
Yeah, that seems reasonable, actually.
Manais tries once again, and, you know, Pasha is ready for it. That's what I mean about predictability. And you're right, it has worked really well, but it's also time to realize when it stops working. And if you do it too late, that's when you just throw a lot of rounds away here. Now they're going to try for an A push coming in. Snags with a really good pick off. Pasha missing a shot, goes for a second one. Wild flashed and smoked off, maybe a little bit too courageous here, but he's actually going to take down Michu again while he's completely flashed, and he's going to get that kill as well. Pasha is rocking 19-2-7 right now. He's outfragging everybody in this game.
Yeah, I think he got a little bit ticked off when he saw Manai's there trying to run away with the top fragging award.
He's like, not on my watch. Yeah, Pasha's not a guy you want to piss off.
Yeah,
real life or CS.
Yeah, he's just been a beast so far. And I don't really see him stopping, because when he gets into a groove like this, he's just unstoppable.
Yeah, it really is. Snacks in the middle is going to get caught off. On the cross, it's Neo over on short. And a great flashbang here is going to set up some very easy kills for him. Neo definitely no stranger to getting a lot of kills either. And that's going to be a quad kill from Neo. Very easily handled. So good job from virtus.pro. I mean, this adjustment is actually pretty overwhelming at this point. It's 9-4. We're talking about two rounds for virtus.pro, then four for ESC. And now another, what, seven in a row coming up for virtus.pro.
And I'm curious to see what ESC plan on doing, because after Manai's cooled off, they haven't been able to get anything going, really. So I want to see if they have something else, something different they can try to get an opening in the VP defense.
Well, once again, it's Manai's up in the apartments, but he's not going to commit to him this time. Not going to run through the smoke. In the middle, Michu's going to pick down Neo. So that is a good opening.
That's solid, actually. Is that the first time they've had an entry in quite some time? I don't know, but...
Yeah, it feels like it.
Spiro, well, let's see whether they decide to take this. virtus.pro going pretty standard, tried and true here. Taz with an AWP up in B apartments is very solid defense for virtus.pro, and you can tell that they have faith in him because they're leaving him alone over on that site, whereas the remaining three members are just gathered up on this A site looking to shut down ESC if they decide to come through a connector.
A bit of a missed opportunity for Taz there, maybe a little bit... he was looking a little bit jumpy over there, actually, trying to check maybe too many angles at the same time. Now he's got Pasha here, so they actually have two scopes up towards the apartments there. They both missed their shots. Taz is going to take down Mausin point blanks. Wow, nice shot on Minai's. That was very done. Well done by Taz. He's going to go down, and actually so is Pasha. So this is still a 2-on-3, and maybe ESC can get that fifth round home after all.
And look at how long ESC wait with their nades as well. They've still got a smoke for Kitchen. They've got Michio alive, looking with that AWP. Find Snacks out the second peak. And this is actually looking like that fifth round here for ESC. Right at the end of this round, at the end of this half as well. Michio with some styling at the end of boot.
Yeah, pretty impressive. We're moving into the 15th round. Of course, ESC have a grotesque amount of money, so they're not going to be worried at all. They can just easily buy here. And I actually, even if this finishes 9-6, if ESC can pick up one more round, I still don't think it's enough for the ESC lineup here. I think if they wanted to have a chance of winning the whole game, I think they'd need to get like 7 or 8 rounds in this first half.
I think that's a fair assessment. I think they need even more than that, but what can you do at this point in the game?
Yeah, with Pasha hitting this hard, I'm just waiting for T-side VP to start rolling around. On Mirage in particular. It's a map that's so difficult to deal with them. Pasha, he's pushed all the way up to top mid with the AWP, finds one kill. Can he make it out of here alive, taking the risk?
Yeah, he gets shot. Like,
that's scary.
He got shot in the heels, I think, coming out there. That was really close. But over by Ramba, actually, Snacks could have maybe picked up Innocent if he had a little bit better timing, but I think they missed each other by a couple of seconds now. The bomb is still all the way back towards the T spawn, so this is just ESC looking for a return frag, I think.
It seems like, I mean, Manai's is going to be backing off from A apartments. Michu will find Pasha through the wall. There is Innocent, and Michu with strikes again picks off Neo. All of a sudden, it's looking pretty good here for ESC. They've got a 2-man advantage. Make that one as Snacks manages to find one, but it's only a 1-for-1 trade, and that's not quite good enough here for VP.
Long range here. Taz will pick off Innocent. And he still has 74 HP. The bomb is actually only just picked up on Michu, making his way through apartments with 20 seconds left. If Taz gets the right kill at the right time here, he can win the round just based on the time. If somehow Michu goes down, that's going to be it.
Well, he doesn't manage to make it through before that molly goes off, but now he's going to be caught in a crossfire. 8 seconds left on the clock, and they finally take him out. Playing that man advantage down to a T. Spiro gets caught, but Michu's there to secure the final frag with 3 total in the round.
But what was Michu doing there? Did you see that? He dropped off the bomb as soon as he got into a safe position, and then he just ran out into the open.
You're like, I am sacrificing myself so you can get the plant.
it seems like that was the thought going through his head, but that could have been really risky if, well, obviously Taz can't really expect that, but yeah, if he picks off Michu there, then that's probably round for virtus.pro.
Yep, that felt like it. So a little bit close here, and actually, just to remind you guys, we do have the article out over at the hltv.org about tomorrow's Case King of the Hill tournament with NIP and LDLC, and of course Na'Vi waiting in the finals. So go and check that out as well. The link's in the chat right here. And remember, if you want to participate in the raffle that's going on in the context of this tournament, it's at the bottom of the page, guys. There's a Facebook link down there, and there's also a YouTube video you can check out, which is a little bit of a commercial that Senra and I made, which is definitely, if nothing else, very funny. And also, you can check out our own YouTube, and there's some other links down there. If you want to help out a little bit, then you'll just read and support. It's really easy. Don't want to go too much into it, because it's just a small thing that we're trying to help out with, but that's it. 16 rounds in, and it's 9-6 here. virtus.pro. I mean, we'll have to see if they can bring this all the way home here. They have a really big lead, and in the pistol round, if they win it, I think that's just going to be a steamroll. There is Innocent, though, going to be picking off Pasha.
Putting up a real fight here, ESC. Getting another entry fragment. Eyes drop down to 50, and Mao's looking towards that A pit, but it is going to be a B play, it seems, after all. Everybody rotating over there for VP. They're gathering up. There's a man holding on short and a man holding by van, though, so the defense is going to be pretty solid for ESC. VP, they're going to have to crack the wall.
It's a good pickoff early on, but now they're all going to be going. I think if Minai's, if he spots them here and just actually falls back, he's going to spot one there, flashes out. That flash fails, and now the Glock train is on. Michu with the kill here. Very nicely done, and Minai's looking for one more, but they're going to go down inside the bomb site. Michu looking for the kill by Ali. It's going to be the only one left, and that works out so well for ESC. Double for Innocent, double for Michu. Even with the failed flashbang, virtus.pro couldn't make it through.
That was just brutal.
But you know you know what's occurring to me here? Because ESC played against Uno Iron the other day, didn't they, on Dust 2?
Yeah.
And I think they got 16-3'd.
Yeah.
And now you're seeing ESC play against virtus.pro.
No, it doesn't. And this is so backwards that Snacks is on his head right now.
Yeah, upside down Snacks.
But that's kind of what you get from, well, it's different maps, and this is also a domestic matchup, and that oftentimes plays a huge role.
Yeah, you're definitely right. That is something that really is hard to take into consideration when you're trying to figure out who's going to win winning what, especially with Taz. Oh my god, what? I thought they were just going to retake that.
Sick. Taz said no. Taz wasn't having any of it.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to tab out and watch that on stream.
I can watch it on stream right now. I'm sorry, I'm gonna do the same thing because I had no idea what just happened.
That was a beast round right there from Taz. Live and get right. Catches the man on electric with the P250 who drops the FAMAS on top of Taz. Taz immediately picks up the FAMAS and mows two guys heading over to that A site. Which was really weird from ESC because Taz just shooting their friend in the face should probably alert the CTs that there's a guy in get right. Maybe you should handle him.
That was a really, really big opening for ESC. Not to quite equalize the score, but to come really, really close, and they just fail it. Michu with a really good pickoff here. Gonna get killed by Niyo immediately afterwards. Actually, this is a 3-on-4, so this game is just completely unpredictable. It's so back and forth. Minai is gonna pick up a kill, goes down to Bayali. But look how low Niyo is. And look where Zero is going right here.
Yeah. That's just picture perfect after Zero. He gets both kills really clean.
Wow.
And this is right back. This feels like a ping pong match. The ball's just getting smacked from one side of the court to the other.
Yeah, it's so back and forth. And it's definitely not what I expected, but kudos to ESC. They're really, really putting up a good fight here. And, surprised to see a team like VP, who are normally so, calculated in their way of or in their style of playing to actually lose to an anti-eco like that, or even though it was kind of a semi-buy anti-eco from ESC, but still.
All right, well, similar, it's gonna have to be virtus.pro winning from here on out for your prediction to be true. Otherwise, ESC is gonna just get another round in, but it's not looking very likely at the moment. Grenades rain in, and actually Taz will pick up the one there. Great shot from Taz, doing one more in, and it's a 1-on-3 here for Bayali. Hiding down for the get right position is gonna be going down. Mouse with the last kill, and we're looking at a 10-9 scoreline. Man,
I'm picturing Obi-Wan Kenobi at the end of this match, where, you know, he says, "And a million voices cried out, and many skins were lost."
Oh God, if virtus.pro win this, yeah, that's gonna be very scary, because I think the odds were like 85% or something in favor of virtus.pro. So yeah, that would be terrifying.
How ridiculously sick!
I still have a feeling that that's pretty far away from happening, to be honest.
Oh, whoa, Manai's, and he makes it out alive.
Now some grenades rain in. He's got backup as well for Michu. So good rotations. ESC, if nothing else, they're really also communicating quite well. And they're going to clean up all of that without any issue at all. Not losing a single member and putting themselves at 10-10. It's been equalized, but now virtus.pro here in the second half, they can finally afford to buy. So let's see where it goes.
Not entirely sure what VP want to go for at this point. They've gone for smokes. And they've gone for straight shots. I don't know, Ben, what do you think is going through VP's head at this point?
I'd like to see them get controller in mid. Just nice and easy, pretty vanilla setups, and just go from there. Because I think individually they're all better players than ESC's team. So I think that's kind of what they have to rely on at this point if they don't... Or if they can't make their set strats work. But we'll have to see. I guess they're in a really awkward position, because if they lose this round, they're back to ecoing, and they haven't really worked up that big of a money bonus that they can buy each and every round right now. So this could actually be the time where ESC can kind of sneak away from VP.
That'd be pretty impressive if they can build up a real round lead, and also a good economy here on the CT side. That's going to be really important. We'll see. Michu's going to be walking right into the middle. Pasha is right down there. And is he going to spot anyone? He spots the head and a quick reaction from Pasha. Very nicely done. That's a big opening now. Now they just need to get past Mouse over here on the ramp, and I think they're going to be just fine.
Yeah, well, Mouse, crucial position, and he gets the job done. Picks up one, and he just backs out into the waiting arms of Neo. Pasha will find Innocent, and now it's all down to zero with the spray. And he lives, takes out Neo, but they're all so low. This is not looking likely here for ESC.
No, so really good round. I mean, especially the opening with Pasha in the middle, and then, yeah, they traded with Mouse over on ramp, but it was still good enough that they could make the entrance. And I think that from there on out, it was just a matter of time before the remaining ESC members got trapped, basically. So that's 10-11, and ESC can still buy, but if they lose this round, they're going to be ecoing, and then virtus.pro are going to kick it into high gear, I imagine.
I imagine as well. And the flash out into mid, is that the opportunity? Michu looking mid. Spiro's there as well. Do they get the chance?
Everyone is just in this middle area. I mean, look at it. It's actually...
What is going on?
They're just flashing everywhere. Michu's now sort of caught here in the whorehouse, as we call it, with the AWP. When he B-peaks, could have easily died to the guy waiting with the AK. It's not an easy shot to hit. Neo's going to take the first kill, and now where are they going? There's nobody at B right now. ESC is making a really strange rotation at the moment, and Bayali goes down. Taz trying to shoot through the smoke up there, not really going to connect with anything. Zero coming up with an auto sniper in hand and takes down Taz.
And he's already looking towards connector as well, so if anybody tries to push up through there, they're going to be very, very sad. Not too much HP on him though, so if they could get the drop, there's the flash in. And for now, VP, they've moved the bomb all the way over to B. They're making their way underpass. But ESC, they smell a rat. They know something's going on here. Michu gets flanked on short, though. Doesn't even see Pasha at mid. And that could be the opening here for VP.
Yeah, that was incredibly unfortunate for him to be looking the wrong way at the wrong time there. Zero is also going to get flanked on by Neo. Timing is perfect here for the legend. But now... actually not so good timing, jumping in with a knife out, maybe not the best idea. Bomb does go down. Snacks could have got killed there, but Pasha is going to be the man of the match, or at least the man of the round here, maybe the whole match actually. Walking up behind, takes an easy kill and leaves Innocent in an almost unwinnable position. Does actually get the kill there, but Snacks should still be able to finish him off really, really easily here.
Yeah, Snax's position makes this really difficult for Innocent. And as soon as he even just goes for the fake on that bomb, Snax just catches. And put ESC down in the hole yet again. ESC, not enough money for a buy.
Yeah, and this is where it really gets out of control almost for ESC, I think, because on the CT side, you really don't want to have to eco every other round, and virtus.pro only 4 rounds away from winning it, so maybe all the people that bet on virtus.pro, they're gonna be feeling a little bit safer soon, but it's obviously not over yet. Oh my god,
We're far from done. Look at Mao. But Pasha gets the jump on him. Mao's looked like he was going to be in a formidable position, but it just didn't play out. And now Pasha, taking the peek, manages to pick off Zero from the A site, and this is now VP site. Neo picking off Innocent, ruining him.
Yeah. AK picked up here on Manais, and he's going to be shot all the way down to middle. Definitely dead, if I've ever seen one. There it is. 13 to 10. 24th round coming up, and yeah, they can buy ones again here. They're going to pick up the AW here on Eyes. I think that's a good idea. Even without the body armor, I think this is still a reasonable choice, because he's been pretty good with it, so they need something to stop the terrorist side here.
Some form of help. Taz smoking off window, though. So that AWP not going to be put to too much use. Unless he could have got the Kenny S block. That would have been pretty slick, but I don't know. Not everybody's Kenny S.
No, very few people. Some would even say there's only Kenny's Kenny S, but I mean, there are certainly contenders for it, right? People trying. We know a guy called Rennie. I mean, definitely trying. Smoking off in that window room, and it's gonna be just a minute left on the clock here, which is enough time for virtus.pro to get something happening. They just need that one pick off, and Neo is gonna get it. Walking up from connector, second one comes in on Michu. Very, very sick opening coming out from Neo. Snax will finish it off here, and it's gonna be Mouse. Actually, what a sick flick from Mouse. That was very fast. Do you see that?
That spray was sick. That was really impressive. I thought he was a goner as soon as the man dropped into Shadow with him. And Manais reads Pasha like a book, catches him peeking out a window. Good anti-flash there to slow Manais down, but still, this is Snax now alive in a 1v1. Manais, is he going to look towards AFs with that AWP? That's the question.
If he had a smoke here, Manais, this would be much more manageable. Yeah, is he not just going to look? He's going to go and check everything, and Snax is going to fall back smartly. He doesn't want to get no-scoped by Manais, but time is running out here. Manais trying to run away, not going to be successful either. Must have had a heart attack when he realized there actually was someone up there. So triple from Snax, a great round, and we're looking at a 14-10 scoreline here. And it will be moving into the 25th round. Another eco coming out from ESC. Well, they forced it up.
It has to be a force. It has to be a force. That's how important that AWP was for Manais, and him losing it like that. That's a real blow dealt to the economy of ESC, because they really just didn't have too much money to put into this round. We can see just by the nades alone, they have 3 nades total. Make that 2 now. It's just not a whole lot to work with.
Oh, it definitely isn't. See if they can finally get another round on the board here. Not with that kind of start. Innocent is going to go down. And if they lose this, they have no money left at all. So this is really all or nothing for the ESC lineup. They've been playing really well, I think, either way. I mean, especially on an individual level, I would say. Some of the ESC players here have really impressed us.
They have, but they're not out of this yet. They've done some tremendous damage here to the VP lineup. This is going to make their lives pretty difficult here for VP. Manais spots a man moving up connector. I believe that was Pasha taking a little bit of damage there. But still, VP maintained that man advantage. They just have to play it right. The only thing is that Zero is going to get spotted. I was about to say, if he started looking back towards ramp with that Mag 7, that could be pretty big.
Yeah, the timing is just like a second off, because he had the angle for it. You're absolutely right. It just doesn't work out. Now virtus.pro coming for the bomb site. Mouse going for the kill here. So is he going to be Michu to pick up one and then two? And now we're in a 3-on-2 situation favoring ESC up until that kill comes in. And Pasha up here with the orb. Not going to hesitate. It's on Manais, the hero of the game so far for ESC. He's going to deny the bomb plant, which is a huge play, but Pasha running with the CSET 75. What a dirty kill to finish off with here. 15-10.
Yeah.
That should be allowed to happen.
That really looked like ESC's round when, I think, yeah, it was Michu, right, who picked up the 2 frags?
Yeah, from Electric.
I really thought that was going to be ESC's round at that point, but Pasha showing how to run and gun.
Oh! Minai's really, really smart there. That was so cool. He hesitated for a moment just to make sure he got that kill. And now it's going to be a 5-on-3, so maybe they can get a little bit higher. And obviously, the most important thing at this point is just that they make it to 12 rounds, just so I end up being right about the prediction. That would be the best thing.
Well, Taz is going to manage to actually find a kill over on B site. That's going to open it up. We already have a man who's rotated over here. Actually, it's still just Taz. They have to actually go back and pick up that bomb, though, VP. And there is going to be someone waiting for them at the top of mid. I believe it's Mouse. He's not going to let it by. Oh, not even Mouse. Mouse is here. It's not Mouse. It's Spiro.
2-on-3. It's still not done yet. The bomb is making its way to B, and they are going to be able to put the bomb down if it just keeps going here. Snags doing a lot of work, but not quite enough. It's a 1-on-2 for Neo, and actually, he might just win this round here.
Yeah, he's going to plant for short right now. And this is going to be so tough for ESC to actually... Well, actually, Minai's does have a smoke, and that's big. So I think Neo actually has to pick off one of the two remaining members early on for him to actually get this round.
Yeah, but how are they going to know where to look? I mean, he's going to wait all the way over here. So you're right, he is planning for short and just going to wait here. And the smoke might just be enough, but are they going to... Yeah, they're going to put it down on the bomb instead of actually towards him. So you can still spot them just fine. There's the one kill. Neo about to steal this round away from ESC. Fate coming out from Innocent. Neo just playing this one so smartly. And he has just years of experience, but it's not going to be enough. Even with the kill, there's no time. 16-10 is going to be the scoreline. And nobody ended up being right. But I guess we still saw some really cool Counter-Strike. I mean, virtus.pro a little bit slow to start. Once they picked it up in the second half, it was hard to stop them. But, great play for Mitru and Minai's on ESC.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's fun to see that, you know, it's not just one team from Poland that can duke it out with the very best.
Absolutely. What a game. That was actually more interesting than I thought it would be. I would have thought that maybe I was worried that it was going to be a stomp. I thought it was either going to be a little bit close or I thought it was going to be an absolute stomp. So I'm glad we got to see something interesting. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that's the last game we have of the evening. But before you go, again, I want to say to you, at the bottom of the stream, there's a bunch of links. So go and click them and check them out. One of them is a Facebook raffle, is a video and some other stuff down there too. And we'll be doing the raffle tomorrow on Facebook because tomorrow is K's King of the Hill time, called by Alpin for in the first game at 6 o'clock Central European time is NIP versus LDLC. That's a best of three game. The winner is going to be playing Navi right afterwards, so you have to tune into that. That's right here on the channel tomorrow, and you will be announcing it on all the social medias as well. So if you click the follow button right here, and you can follow all the different Twitters, and you'll be able to know exactly what's happening when. So that's definitely a good idea. Apart from that, if you want to support the channel, you can stick around and watch some ads. Just put it on low quality, put it on mobile quality, and just mute the channel, and you can still help us out with that. And I think that's pretty much it. Semler and Ven, anything else we need to say before we go?
No, well, just thanks for tuning in. I think we definitely had our great game of a great day of CS.
Yeah.
So yeah, and it's gonna be better tomorrow, believe it or not, because we're
that's
gonna
the
have,
thing. Tune in tomorrow, guys.
Yeah, we're gonna have a best of three between NIP and LDLC, and a best of three with Navi and whoever wins that first best of three. So
yeah.
Damn.
Absolutely. Well, that's it, guys. Have a great evening. Play some Counter-Strike and just have fun. Come back tomorrow and we'll give you